constantly thinking of really creative things and how I can make something out of nothing or make something that someone has not done yet. And we're artists, and we're not allowed to be stopped by anyone, you know, like no one can stop your creative process, like no one can stop you from doing anything you really want, because, you know, it's you, it's your body. You know, like I said, dancing was that outlet to like kind of help me figure out what I kind of wanted to do, but not fully until like bigger things happen, you know? And that's when I'm like, oh, there's the picture. Like that's what it's painted. Okay, that's what I want to do. So, I mean, I felt like it was like that. And I really didn't have no idea that I would be where I'm at right now. I really did never envision it. Dressing like them, cutting hair like them, moving like them. There's only one of them. Okay, so you don't have to look like them, move like them. Left arm, feet come up, and then they drop. Okay, when they drop, leave your legs fully extended. If your feet are like this, you're not gonna get around. It's gonna look real weird. And one more on this side. And we just swing, your hands up. Yeah? Other side. Down to you guys, gonna be a lot of information that I learned from a lot of the pioneers that taught me and pretty much have got me to where I'm at right now. I need you guys to spread out. We'll go ahead and stretch out real quick, and then we're gonna go over some drills. Fifth stop in Houston, Texas at Break Free Studios, so come and check it out. Right foot, one, two, three, kick.
changing your moves around that.
Yeah. That's another thing. I won't say that you can't be able to physically do something if you have a certain body type. Because I've seen people that are overweight and they can hit air flippers. I mean, I'm sure that they went out there and, you know, trained their ass off to the point that they have the move, or they developed that movement, you know? With Cindy.
Hi.
And we're having breakfast right now. I'm about to make a smoothie for us, and she's about to make some scrambled eggs for us. As you see, she's been taking care of us so great over here in Oklahoma City for the first time ever. And this is our first smoothie on our whole road trip.
Toughest battle.
I would say all of them, man. Let me tell you that. I would say all of them because it took a lot of training, and it's never about the other guy. Okay. It's mostly about myself.
Right.
Because my mental preparation, my physical preparation, you know, how I feel that day and how I feel that day determines on how, you know, I'm gonna do. I think that's it's good and bad, you know. I think the good of it is the fact that you can receive a lot of information real fast, and you can get good really fast. You know, like your skills could be like at the very top in 1 year because you have tutorials and you have all these people that are like pioneers are sharing their information out there, and it's just only a click away. You know what I mean? Now the bad thing about it is, I feel like a lot of people tend to copy some of these pioneers and redo them instead of actually recreating it in their own way, which is like kind of like what are you offering to the dance? You know what I mean? Like, don't repeat something. What can you offer to it? Like, what can you put in? You know, like the same idea how Steve Jobs came out with that, the only concept of the apple. You know what I mean? Like, it's like he's the only apple. There's no other apple. Like, there's no pear. There's no grapes, no orange, no none of that. Apple, like, that's all you got, you know? And that to me is fascinating, you know? I think it's very cool. And that is what they're missing, you know?
Yeah, people.